school cafeteria group up. We done a research project on title impact of human activity on irrigation canal with my friends Priyadeshni, Mani, Charmi and Sabriwasan. The aim of my studies is to know about the irrigation system of my village, to appreciate the mathematics in canal construction, to record the factors that support and disturb canal irrigation, to find a solution to strengthen canal irrigation. In olden days, we have good number of water bodies in our village. But due to population and so, we have explored agricultural land that converted into houses and water bodies are sinked by encroachment. So we conduct a study to understand the present status of irrigation canals.
Methodology, we adapted survey method and experimental method for doing this project. We conducted survey with farmers and the agricultural officials of our village. They provided our village map and help us to locate the various type of water bodies. Our village have 4 lakes and 7 ponds and more than 25 wells. The design of water flow is amazing. When water is opened from a Vidu dam, it fills the lake on its way to fill the pond. Then leads to Puducherry, biggest lake Puducherry. If the water comes in surplus, it gets connected to the river Sangrabani. This flows adjacent to my village. During our interview with the elders, we came to know the reason behind our village name Kateri Kuppam, which means Kaderi Kuppam, village in between forest area with fishing habitat.
Experiment with canal. This GPRS instrument used to find length and area of a place. We validated this instrument by comparing the value shown in our GPRS instrument with the length of the canal measurement manually. Difference between them is negligible. Then we use this instrument to find the length and perimeter of water body. For our experiment, we select a ringoid polyum to Kateri Kuppam irrigation canal. Total length of the canal 1.3 km. To measure depth and width of the canal at every 20 meters. The average depth of the canal 1.7 meters and width is 6.5 meters.
During our observation, it was very surprised. All the canal is trapezoid shape. To then notice then why our ancestors designed canals trapezoid shape instead to rectangular shape. So we study the volume of both type of canal. The water flows up to 50 cm height and length is 1 meter. The rectangular canal hold 1500 liters water. The trapezoid canal hold 1000 liters water. The water flows to its full volume. The rectangular canal hold 5000 liters water. The trapezoid canal hold 8075 liters. That is 3,000 liters more. The trapezoid shape canal help to prevent our village from flood during rainy season.
Biodiversity study. We constructed quotient of 1 meter at 10 different places and studied the type of flora. We recorded different species of flora in our quotient. With grass type plants were recorded in large numbers. Cynodon, cypress, leopardia are also found in abundance. Edible plants like kuppai kirai and ponnangani kirai are found in large numbers. Medicinal plants like kuppai neri, amalipa, amman pacharisi, leopardia, tulasi, asimam are found there. 4 number of trees are found inside and peripheries of the canal. Planting trees and castor plants are found in large numbers.
Manav study, we dug the ground 30 cm depth and 3 different places. And we recorded the insects, found the beetles and small insects are large in number. The 95 earthworms are recorded in our coordinates. It shows that soil is very healthy and have good nutrients. Avifauna. We noticed 11 types of avifauna during our canal. We see Asian palm trees and rango are considerable in number. Grass species, spotted owlet is during our observation.
Impact of human activity on canal. Population explosion disturbs the irrigation canal very much. The flow of water from road to irrigation canal disturbs, blocks the thick vegetation and human encroachment. The canal have 19 water lakes in our experimental area, 1.3 kilometers. If blocks the flow of water, if rain heavily, it results sudden emerge of flood. Water lakes only allow 2,230 liters of water, so it is impossible for 5,453 liters. Thick and clear vegetation in the canal also blocks the flow of water. Inlet of water into the Purakulam pond is blocked by the pollution.
in the shore of the pond is enclosed by 21 hours. We conduct a cleaning camp on the shore and remove the garbage. Quadrant study of 3 meter into 3 meter was conducted. We found that thermocol sheets, dead animals, plastic covers and household waste are found at there. The passage of the water under the bridge is blocked by the household waste.
This project is an eye-open for us and makes us to realize the status of my own village irrigation canal. Canals and water bodies is gift of nature, designed and preserved by our ancestors. It should be maintained and handled over our future generation. It reaches groundwater and makes our life possible. The preserved shape of the canal must be maintained since holds more water during rainy season and prevent us from sudden rise of flood. The canals must be desilted at the interval of time by government and local farmers. Representation is given to village administrative officers regarding construction to separate drainage canal and control irrigation canal. We cleaned the shore of the Papankulam pond and conducted an awareness drive that distributing payments to the public. We convey our thanks to Pondicherry Science Forum and Paris University. Thank you.